And in the Impact segment tonight, as we discussed with Donald Trump last night, the left is trying to brand him as racist.
He's whipping up hatred to scapegoat a minority religious group, which has some very dangerous historic precedents, as you might agree. I mean, it's the kind of behavior that it's classic demagoguery. And, you know, he's going to get somebody hurt.
This is just terrible. You have a presidential candidate who is deliberately stoking fear and smearing a whole population of people.
Of course, Mr. Trump denies any racial animus, and I've known him for 25 years. I've never seen that out of him. Nevertheless, the issue is in play. With us, Dana Perino, co-host of The Five. So the strategy, as far as I see it, and I told this to Mr. Trump last night, is that they're trying to, they being the left and the Democrats, are trying to brand him as a racist guy, all right, for his comments on Mexicans, his comments on Muslims. He retweeted, as he pointed out to me, the black statistics on crime, which were incorrect. And then, by extension, they're trying to sell the fact that all Republicans are racist. Do you see it that way?
It's certainly true, because this is their playbook from the early 60s,
right.
And for any Republican, which is why I've always held the rule that Republicans start in a credibility deficit, especially on race. And so you have to work your way up just to get to neutral. And one of the dangerous things is, if you're trying to communicate to a broad audience, multiple audience, and you're running a national election, is that if you give them ammunition with which to hit you, it's hard then to crawl up out of that hole and get to neutral.
But here's the difference between Donald Trump and all the other politicians. He doesn't care.
He doesn't care.
He does not care. He's made it quite clear that he wants to deport all illegal aliens. And a new poll from Fox today shows that majority of Americans, over 50%, agree with that. Deport them all. All right, he doesn't care if Muslims are offended by surveillance, special surveillance for them. Doesn't care. All right. So while he may not have personal racial animus, and I'm the guy, I never saw anything like that. All right, his policies can be defined that way by the opposition. And I don't know whether he even cares about that.
Well, he might not care if he thinks that he's able to win that way. I don't know if it's a good way to think about winning a general election. But to the point about the Republican Party, the unfavorables for the Republican Party are about 55%, right? It's got a 35% approval rating in the country. So right now, it's like it's hard to get any worse. And so I don't know what is happening overall. I mean, perhaps Pew will come back next year and say, maybe because of Donald Trump, the Republican Party brand is now more favorable. I kind of find that hard to believe.
But, in an era where we're seeing President Obama collapse, and he is, the presidency's collapsing before the public's eyes. And the public acknowledges that in the polling. All right, it's collapsing. That the Republican Party should be the big victor, but it isn't right now anyway.
Right. When the other when President Obama was overseas talking about refugees, the first thing he did was attack Republicans. And he gave them no credence to think that maybe we should just have a pause. If you look at the difference between Trump on refugees and Paul Ryan, who's actually in a position of governing at least right now, what he did was he was able to say, look, let's have a reasonable response. Let's have some common sense. We're going to have a pause. And what was he able to do? He got 76 Democrats to vote with him, despite President Obama's ill-thought-out veto.
But Trump knows the only way he's going to win, the nomination, is to throw bombs and to be the anti-politician. So he knows that. He can't moderate these positions, because then his chances of winning the nomination would fall, right?
Well, they're unpersuasive to me, and I think to maybe a lot of other Republicans, but
He's ahead.
He has tapped into a vein of people that are frustrated. And I actually put that back on President Obama. I think the incompetence and the lack of leadership and a feeling across America, like, what are you doing? What happened to our country? And they see someone like Trump, who is the opposite.
Right.
They tend to want to follow it.
And they are. And he could win, as I told Karl Rove very gently last night. Trump could win Iowa, New Hampshire, and South Carolina. Bing, bing, bing. So, I mean, to dismiss him as somebody who doesn't have the credibility,
that's
foolish.
I think that a lot of people who thought that he could never win the nomination are coming to the realization that he actually could.
It's possible.
It is.
Not,
but it is still a little bit early.
Not a lot.
And you saw Ted Cruz in Iowa.
Early,
is already
Cruz is coming up in Iowa, but It is. Trump has really captured something.
Something.
And the Republican Party has got to kind of.
And they have to
line.
Understand that what Ellison was saying is that that is what the Democrats are going to say, is that they're going to paint Republicans with a broad brush. But that is actually going to be true of any of them.
Okay, Dana Perino is directly ahead. Sympathy.